Hey guys, what's up, Crazy Puerto Rican? Here today to review Kuro Kono Basket Season 3, Episode 7. Now, I'm late to this review again because the episode came out subbed yesterday, because on Saturday they didn't sub it. They usually sub it Saturday afternoon, but they didn't sub it this time. On Saturday afternoon, so I had to wait, and yesterday I got home late, and I wanted to watch the Oscars, so I didn't really want to do the review, didn't feel like doing a review yesterday. But anyways, we are back today, and yeah, well, the episode starts with, of course, Rakusan beating Shutoku, and when Midorima goes to shake Akashi's hand, Akashi says, like, this was a hard-fought game, but I cannot accept your handshake because you need to be less merciful to win the game. So I cannot accept that. And Midorima says, you haven't changed at all. And it was really a really intense moment. But the part that really got me was when the captain of Shutoku said, hey, we're not the only ones who fought. Everyone line up where the people are watching from Shutoku, and they say thank you for all your support. And I almost cried in that part. It was very amazing. Then they're heading back to the locker room, Takao saying, are you emotional and stuff? But he's the first one to cry, saying that he can't cheer him up right now. Then Midorima says, of course, it was a regretful loss. And that's understandable, of course. Then finally we get the game that probably everyone's been waiting for, Seirin and Kaijo. Now Seirin actually has a strategy. Riko said, let's start by taking a huge lead, because I bet Kiyosei's not going to use his perfect copy like right off the bat. He's going to wait until the final minutes, and so he doesn't have a chance to come back. Let's take the big lead. Well, it was awesome because Kuroko starts using the Vanishing Drive, then the Phantom Shot, there, boom, first 2 points of the game to Seirin. And it was really, really cool. But after that, the ball just goes flying and gets into the net. Kisei starts using the perfect copy right off the bat. They got Riko. Riko really didn't think that was going to happen. Now, Coach was like, damn it, he got me. And the other coach, the coach from Kaijo, said, you're not gonna catch me off guard, so yeah, I'm not letting you win this one. Which, of course, the last one, you didn't let him win, but, you know, Kagami was the first game. You can't let the main team lose on the first game. Well, anyways, they start because, you know, Kuroko has kind of hated Kisei, but in a good way, kind of like his rival. And it was really, really cool. Oh my god, but Kisei was basically unstoppable. And when I say unstoppable, I mean unstoppable. He's using the perfect copy. Of course, he's not going to use all the minutes he has of the perfect copy right off the bat. He's going to save up some from the end to the end. So I bet he's only going to use like half, and then use the half at the end. And Riko says he's not going to use them all, but Kagami's zone is the only thing that can really stop Kisei right now, and judging by the last games, Kagami can't get in the zone right after the game starts, so yeah. Anyways, the part that I fanboyed like, was when Kisei, in the perfect zone, used Akashi's Emperor Eye and broke Kagami's ankles, and I was like, oh, he can even copy the Emperor Eye? I mean, if he can copy the Emperor Eye, then Seirin is like fucked, because you saw what happened to Shutoku. Oh, they tried. If you can copy the Emperor Eye, they're fucked. Of course, he's not. That's with the perfect copy. If not, he's just gonna copy their other move. This is gonna be a close game all the way, anyways. So after that happens, they pass the ball to Shutoku. To Kuroko. Jesus Christ, what's wrong with me? To Kuroko, and Kuroko is gonna use the Phantom Shot, because even if Kisei can use Murasakibara's block, Murasakibara wasn't able to block the Phantom Shot. Well, Kuroko shoots it up, and boom! Kisei stops it, saying, I can stop it, because he used both Emperor's Eye and Murasakibara's jump to know the trajectory. And you were like, oh, shit, he can stop the Phantom Shot? And he said, it's not, you don't have no choice, you have to shoot it, because you can't pass it. I won't let you pass it. So Kuroko shot it, and he got blocked. That was, damn. And this game is gonna be really close, I believe. This is just the beginning. So, yeah. In the episode preview, though, we get to see that they sub in one of the reserves, and he really doesn't play that well. So I don't know why. We'll probably get an explanation in the next episode. And yeah, overall, it was a really good episode. I mean, Kisei using the Emperor Eye. Obviously, my favorite part of the whole episode wasn't part of the game. Was when Shutoku lined up in where the players are. The people from Shutoku High School are cheering, and they say thank you for the game. For supporting us throughout this. That was just my favorite part of the episode. So, yeah, anyways, tell me what you guys thought about this episode. And I can't wait for the next episode. I don't know if you can't either. So, yeah, leave your comments below. Remember to subscribe. Later, guys.